8countnews.com. Peter Zimbor here with you in Lincoln, Rhode Island, and I run to who else but a consummate fan favorite, the Bean, Butterbean. What brings you to Rhode Island?
Well, you know, I'm a big guy, so I'm everywhere.
Aside of geographics, what brings you here?
Well, you know, I'm promoting a show in Worcester, not far from here, a big MMA show, May 21st, and, you know, I want to check out. There's fights in town. Mickey's going to be here. Me and Mickey Ward are good friends, so, you know, I had to stop by and see old friends.
Now, what made you want to transition from the fight game as a boxer and an MMA competitor to the promotional game?
Well, I went from boxing to wrestling to MMA. What's next? You got to do some promoting.
You're a jack of all trades, aren't you?
I'll do it all.
Now, as far as this card you have coming up here in New England is concerned, it's a pretty stacked card from top to bottom. Main event, former UFC heavyweight champion Tim Sylvia taking on five-time world's strongest man. Tell us what we've got going on.
Well, Mariusz Pudzianowski is like a legend in Europe. And we signed him to come fight, you know, Tim Sylvia on the card as our main event. It's going to be phenomenally big. It's one of the biggest cards Europe's ever seen. I mean, it's big for the U.S. We're not, you know, Moosin, our company, is not doing like UFC, only like American-type fighters. We're picking fighters from all over the world. We got people from Korea, Poland, all over the world coming in to fight on our card. More like the old Pride.
And Moosin, for our viewers that are unaware, is a company that originated in Korea, correct?
In Korea, correct.
And has now made its way to your home of Alabama, and now it's making its way to New England and Worcester, May 21st. That's where this card will take place live on pay-per-view for those unable to attend live now. Tim Sylvia, a lot of people know from his days in the UFC. He also fought for Affliction and a number of other of major promotions. A big stand-up fighter, world's strongest man. What can you tell us about him as a fighting competitor? We know what he can lift. What can he do as far as fighting is concerned?
Well, there's not many guys big enough. Just grab Sylvia up and pick him up and slam him. Pudzianowski's the one that can do that. He can just manhandle him like a little girl. But you know what? Sylvia's got the tools to defend himself if you don't get intimidated. Pudzianowski's very intimidating.
Now, I mentioned that outside of this main event, there are also some other noteworthy bouts on the card. Travis Luter, former UFC alum, is competing, and you got some Pride alum fighting as well.
Yeah, I mean, Jae Young Kim, you know, we got some of the big Koreans coming in that's fought Pride, K-1. It's a real deal. I mean, it's a card that it's stacked. I mean, it's a stacked card. All the fights are going to be really entertaining. Nobody wants to miss this card.
Well, we'll look forward to seeing it. One thing I want to ask you about before I even knew of this next story we're about to get into was you're a guy who's transitioned from boxing into mixed martial arts. The big headline the past few weeks of someone doing that is James Lights Out Toney has signed a contract with the UFC. Before we get how you think he'll fare in the MMA world, it's my understanding that there was a bit of a business transaction gone wrong. He almost ended up fighting for you.
Well, we had a verbal commitment from James. I've known James for 20-something years, and, you know, we had a verbal commitment. And then, you know, I can tell one story, or I can tell another story, but what happened was, I guess UFC heard wind, and they said, you know, they shipped him off to Vegas the day he went to the attorneys, but everything worked out. James said, Bean, it's done. You can do the press release. It's all ready. So he slipped off to Vegas. Dana gave him stupid money to sign. You know what? James can be difficult to work with sometimes. Dana, have fun with your circus act.
Now, James Toney, as a professional boxer, I think is a surefire first ballot Hall of Famer. But one thing I find interesting about him, his characteristics as a boxer were always to stand close, use quick little swift movements to avoid punches and things of that nature. And I think to myself, how well is that going to work in MMA in a game where your opponent can tackle you?
Well, I fought all over the world, and I fought with a lot of their boxers coming over. I fought Fujimoto, knocked him out in the first round. Francois Botha went to fight Fujimoto, and he got his legs just chopped off from underneath him. Boxers got to adapt. Some of them don't know how. I don't know what James is going to do. I don't know how prepared he's going to be. He's either going to be really good because he's a true athlete, or it's going to be a circus act.
Was the adaptation from boxing to MMA difficult for you? Was it one that you felt you made rather well?
I took steps. I went from boxing to K-1, which is stand-up kickboxing, to MMA. And it was a lot of adapting. You know, if it wasn't for American Top Team, I'd be in a lot of trouble.
And you mentioned your wrestling career earlier, which I briefly forgot about. How's Bart Gunn doing, Janelle?
Bart's still out. He's still out.
And what's interesting is Vinny Paz is going to be here tonight. He was the referee, if I recall.
Vinny was the referee, yeah. He done a good job on it. It wasn't much to do, but yeah.
He counted from 1 to 10 very well. Butterbean, a pleasure speaking with you.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much. That's Butterbean joining us here, 8countnews.com.